We've already seen how the amino acid side chains can function as general acids and general bases. Here we'll take a look at an example where an amino acid side chain functions as a nucleophile in nucleophilic catalysis. The different amino acids that can function in nucleophilic catalysis are shown here. It's sometimes called covalent catalysis, and the reason for that is because each of the atoms that I'm going to highlight in these side chains are able to form a covalent bond with the substrate that they react with. I won't take you through each of these in this webcast in any kind of detail. We'll talk about some of them in upcoming webcasts. Rather, we're going to focus on just one example. We'll look at the role of lysine when it functions as a nucleophile, using the enzyme as an example, acetoacetate decarboxylase. Really, the main point, the thing I want you to get used to, is that whenever you see lysine in the enzyme active site, together with a substrate that involves a carbonyl group, we ought to be thinking about nucleophilic catalysis in which we form the iminium ion. So the iminium ion has the structure shown here. It's going to end up making a better electron sink, and as we'll see on the next slide, that's going to enhance the acidity of the alpha carbon. So there is several examples of the role of lysine as a nucleophile, and it always involves this iminium group. So let's take a look at that. Here we see the formation of the iminium ion. The iminium ion is formed with the loss of water. As I said, it is a better electron sink than the original carbonyl because of the protonated nitrogen atom. What that does is it enhances the acidity of this hydrogen, so now the acidity is recognized as being much more acidic than the original alpha carbon of the acetone molecule. pKa of 11 means that we can deprotonate that under physiological conditions to make the corresponding enamine. Doing so generates a nucleophilic carbon at the alpha position, and so rather than form the enolate, we end up making the enamine a nucleophilic atom nonetheless, but it's able to be made without having to make that very basic enolate anion. So again, if we were to just compare the pKa of that acetone molecule originally had a pKa of about 20, it would be very difficult, as I've mentioned before, to deprotonate that under physiological conditions. Before I show you the example of acetoacetate decarboxylase, let's take a look at the evidence that this forms, and the way that scientists have come to know that the iminium ion is actually formed is by performing a reaction on the enzyme that's known as reductive amination. Reductive amination involves the addition of a nucleophilic hydride source, so H-. H- adds in to the iminium group by an AD sub N step, and the result of that is this new carbon-hydrogen bond. That's now a stable entity. In other words, it's irreversibly bound to the enzyme, so that when peptide sequence analysis is done, when amino acid sequence analysis is done, rather than obtaining a lysine, one obtains a lysine where the amino group is covalently bound to the substrate molecule. That's the way that scientists have come to realize that this intermediate, the iminium ion intermediate, forms in nucleophilic catalysis. Let's take a look at an actual example, acetoacetate decarboxylase. Here's the overall reaction. Acetoacetate is the structure shown here. It's a dicarbonyl compound where carbon dioxide is lost. A decarboxylation event takes place that's catalyzed by this enzyme. CO2 is lost. Charge balance is maintained. So we had a negative charge here. It actually is believed to be passed on to an amino acid side chain that was originally in its protonated form. Okay, so that's the overall stoichiometry. What's the mechanism by which this reaction takes place? Well, it forms the iminium ion. As you might guess, lysine is an important, you can see, is an important amino acid active site side chain. It ends up forming this iminium ion, and as I've said, that's now a better electron sink. So rather than doing a deprotonation, what happens is a decarboxylation event to form that iminium, that enamine ion. So CO2 is lost, and the structure that forms now is this enamine structure. The enamine structure is then hydrolyzed, first by becoming the iminium ion, so we're going to pick up that proton on that side chain that served as the acid. The iminium ion that forms from the enamine is now hydrolyzed, and H2O is added in. we've released the molecule of acetone and regenerated the ammonium group on the lysine.